The Chieftains failed to reproduce the high-paced rugby that had been a feature of their opening two victories, but found a new way to win. In a lot of ways, it's good that we came through the challenge. If you look at the wet conditions, slippery ball. All our plaudits so far have been about playing with width and tempo, said Cairns. It's much harder, obviously, when it's a slippy ball. There's certainly big parts we need to improve, like our game management, when the weather doesn't allow us to play. The big part for us now is to learn from it. When you play the same brand of rugby in the same weather for the first 2 weeks, you are probably not learning as much. And of the upcoming fixtures, he added, it's a big run. We have to treat it as one game at a time. I know that is a big cliche, but it is so true. If you take your eye off the ball for 1 minute, then it doesn't matter who you are playing, they will beat you. The Chieftains were given a stern test by a Muir side that displayed ample amounts of courage to battle back from a deficit of 130 at halftime to lead with 10 minutes remaining. However, as they had done in their opening loss to Ayr, the hosts failed to see out the game. That was a source of frustration for coach Peter Wright. We are really disappointed. I thought at 15-13, we were in the ascendancy. We worked really hard in the second half to get into the game by box kicking, keeping a hold of the ball, and putting pressure on at the set piece, said Wright. And it all worked. We got a couple of tries and got ourselves in the lead. Then when we went in the lead, we just decided to play a completely different game. We kicked the ball away, and we gave away possession, sometimes to really good defense, sometimes to really naive mistakes. A try by Mike Vernal was converted by Jamie Forbes, who was also on target with two penalties, to hand the visitors the lead at halftime. Chris Laidlaw kicked a penalty and converted a try by Lewis Carmichael before creating a score for Greig Kenny as Muir edged ahead. But the Chieftains regained their lead with a penalty by Forbes, and he added the conversion after Vince Wright bagged the match-winning try with 5 minutes to play. Also in the capital, Watsonians secured their first points of the campaign with a 38-26 win over Stirling County at Myerside. Jamie Farndale topped and tailed the Sonians try-scoring. His first, together with touchdowns from James Miller and Craig Borthwick, all converted by Andrew Chalmers, left Sonians 21-14 ahead at halftime. And, although the visitors squared matters, further touchdowns by Rory Houghton and a second for Farndale sealed the win, with Chalmers booting both conversions and a penalty. There was also an upturn in fortunes for Heriots, who clicked into gear to take all 5 league points from a tense 29-26 success against previously unbeaten Glasgow Hawks at Scotstoun. Skipper Rory Carmichael touched down for the first of Heriots' 4 tries, and Ross Jones converted and then added a penalty. Michael Linus claimed a 5-pointer as Heriots reached the break 26-15 adrift. Further scores by Adam Sinclair and Craig Robertson, both converted by Jones, turned the game in favor of Heriots. And, in contrast to the previous 2 weeks, Phil Smith's men saw out a tight game to break their duck for the season.